Alright guys, how many times have you ever had this happen? You have a car, breaks down, you know, it's at the end of its life. So what do? Well, you take it to the scrapyard, right? Send it over the scales and, you know, get the weight and get the money and you leave it there. And they scrap it. Well, we don't need to scrap anything, but we do need to know the weight of something. Let's go see how much this bad boy weighs. Let's go! Alright, got our slip. Now let's head back and discuss what we've learned. Okay, so why are we weighing the car to begin with, right? What's going on? You know, I didn't explain anything at the start of this video. Well, here's the deal, right? We're building a car for No Name Nationals. I mean, she's gonna run, okay? We got big plans for it, but a lot of you guys, new to the channel, you know, you've maybe watched previous videos on the car, but you're not fully up to date on what it really is and what we're working with here. It's the most typical hot rod anybody's gonna have. It's got an open diff, you know, 355 gears, open differential. It's got a worn out 289, you know, burns oil, has a lifter tick, right? Worn down, doesn't make a lot of power, right? But we're gonna take this combination that we have right now and we're gonna fine tune it, optimize it to the point where we can get this thing ready to run some numbers at No Name. Okay, that's the goal, right? We have a 302 engine build that's gonna go in it. Technically a 327 stroker, a standard bore 331 stroker crank with standard bore pistons that makes a 327 stroker. But that's not until, you know, a little bit later in the summer. Right now, we got to work with what's in it, that 289. It's going to get some laughing gas, don't you worry. But right now, we have to establish a baseline, right? Nobody knows anything about the car. We need to establish what are we working with. Well, there's two major things you got to know before you can really start working on your car effectively. You have to know how much it weighs. You have to know how much power it makes. Those are the two things, right? Also, a time slip down a drag strip would also be handy. But power to weight ratio, you need to know the power and you need to know the weight. And well, today we have the weight. Now, I want you to take a guess. How much does this car weigh with me in it as it sits, okay? I didn't even clean it out. It doesn't have the toolbox in it, but it's got everything else, jack stands, you know, a jack, it's got, you know, gauges, just lying in the back seat, right? I didn't even clean it out yet. How much you think it weighs? She weighs, on the starting line, as she sits right now, half tank of gas, 3,220 pounds. That's not bad for starting out, and there's still a lot of weight savings we can do on it. We got the front runners, that's gonna shave some weight. We're gonna get some new back tires, which is gonna shave some weight too, because I think we're gonna go narrower. Gonna go narrower, but better compound. So, that's what we're working with. And next we gotta figure out how much power is it gonna make. I gotta figure out where I'm going to bring it to find that out. But after we find that out, then we need to know what kind of time slips is it running currently down drag strip. Once we have those three pieces of information, we can go from there and start fine tuning, tweaking all those different parameters to better improve our time. So I hope you follow along. Because that's what we're up to. I'll catch you next time.